I'm Dan Emery.
And we're the team at Welcome to 1979 Electroplating Facility. And we're going to give you a quick tour of our processes and our place. So we've been doing this almost 2 years now. And if you haven't seen a plating facility before, this is going to be a nice inside look. If you've been at once in the past, you'll see what we do differently. And we'll show you some new technology. So the first step when we get lacquers is the lacquer prep room. This is a separate room. The store is normally closed so the dust particles don't get out into our plating facility. Right now, Dan is taking the back off the lacquer to expose the aluminum. Next, he'll take the edges off of the lacquer to expose it so we can make a complete circuit with silver that you'll see next around the whole thing. This is electroplating, so you need to expose the aluminum. So when it's in the bath, we have a complete circuit and everything flows perfectly. So the second step, and arguably the most important step, is lacquer cleaning and silvering. This is our cleaning and silvering booth. It's fully automatic, so it's done the same every day and every time. And we silver every day. We don't let lacquer sit at all, which is a very important part with quality and high frequency content on records. This reduces pre-echo and fidelity loss. So what you'll see here in a second is Dan is rinsing right now, getting the cleansing chemical off. He's going to put it on here, and this will automatically spray silver onto the lacquer. This is where the plating process begins. This is super critical. If this isn't done right, then everything else is going to be compromised. So we put a lot of time and effort into this. Now that the lacquer has been silvered and rinsed with deionized water, there's more deionized water there, and it's off to the next step, another very important step called pre-plating, which I'll show you in a second. So this is our pre-plate system. What this does is it's the same chemical in here, but a lower temperature and lower amperage, and it operates differently. This will take our lacquers with silver on them and go back and forth. Again, at a low temperature, low current, to gently introduce the lacquer to a different environment. We'll put a thin layer of nickel on here. They're in here for about 20 minutes, and then they'll go into our high-speed plating. This coupled with our automatic silvering booth and processing lacquers as they come in, will greatly reduce pre-echo and noise. This is a very important step as well. Okay, so this lacquer is out of the pre-plate. We put a ring on it, so when it's in here, the nickel doesn't form around there on solid beads, we can't separate it. You'll see separating in a minute. So he's putting in these. This is the same solution that's in our pre-plate. There are nickel pellets in here. But this runs about 10 degrees Celsius hotter, and the amps ramp up from 0 to about 185 amps, where the pre-plate is 20 amps. These are state-of-the-art new rectifiers that are programmable. So we've got different programs we run for different plants to get the precise thickness and weight for each damper. All 10 of our baths do have these same rectifiers and do the same exact thing. This is very important too because your A-side stamper and B-side stamper should be very close in weight so the heat transfer is the same. And plants like certain weights, and we can deliver that every time we put a stamper. All right, this is that lacquer out of the high-speed plating. We've got our nickel on the back of it. It's about 111 microns of nickel. He's going to separate this now, and this will have ridges, not grooves, and then it'll get cleaned and put back in the plating to make a mother, which has grooves, and then that will get plated, which will have stampers. It's called a three-step process. Notice how carefully he peeled it off there. He didn't bend it too much. He didn't rotate it. It didn't cause any bends or scuffs. So a good visual inspection and another cleaning, and we'll go back in the baths. So we do three-step plating, which I just described. We also do a two-step, where that would become a stamper. And we do one step where we just do that, and that's a stamp of no mother. So Dan is about to separate a father, oh, I'm sorry, a mother from a stamp of power. That's the mother right there. That has grooves, and we'll talk about that a little later when I show you the QC room. The stamper, which is here, is our finished product, but it's not quite done yet. We're gonna head over to forming, and I'll talk about that. Okay, this is our forming room. Again, a separate room to keep dust away from where we clean lacquers and process parts. This room is where we customize the stamper for the plant it's going to. The mother, which you saw separated, is in the QC room. Once it's QC'd and the noise floors are verified, we go ahead and proceed with the stamper. And you'll see these lights everywhere, and you'll see more in the QC room in a second. This helps us get really close-up lighting. There are also magnifying glasses. We're always looking at these parts for any imperfection. So this is a centering device here. We have got multiples for the different plants. They have different requirements as far as a center hole. We center it here, punch a hole in it. Then it goes here, and it gets back sanded smooth. Then it goes over here, and the outer diameter gets trimmed based on the perfect center. Then over here, we form it based on the plant's specification, so our stamper will fit their press perfectly. Last step is one final check with lights and a magnifying glass. We weigh each part, clean it again, wrap it in saran wrap so no dust will get in, and then put it in one of our envelopes with who did the quality control, what the weights are, and the date, and we ship it. This is our quality control room. This allows us to take a look at issues when they do arise and figure out where the problem is and move the project forward with confidence. We can listen to our mothers here, which remember are metal parts with grooves, and we can monitor noise floor on every project, and if there happens to be a pop or a click, we can listen to that, make sure it's not on the mother, capture that digitally and send it off to our client or clients so they can verify that this step is fine. That means the lacquer is good, the father's good, the mother's good, so we can just send them another stamper or just have them do another set of test pressings. So this room is very important, and we can also fix some things here, but the idea is that we have a communication with our clients, whether it be a cutting engineer or a label or a plant, and we can work together and get problems solved quickly. I hope you enjoyed the tour of our facility. Again, our goal is to work with cutting engineers, record labels, and record plants to make the best quality records possible. So we have a dialogue with people. If you have any questions, just hit us up, Dan, at welcome1979industries.com, or go to our website, welcome1979industries.com, and our phone number is there. This is a pretty basic overview of what we do. There's a lot more steps involved, but I wanted to show you guys the basic steps, so to kind of take the mystery out of it. But plating is a very important step in the record making process, and you should know who's doing your plating, and know that it's going fair, and have a dialogue with them. If you have any questions, let us know.